the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And please be seated. Once again, welcome as we gather in worship this morning. Welcome to those of you who gather here in church, and to those of you joining us from home. We gather as one people of God in one spirit, with, I hope and pray, one heart of thanksgiving for the gifts of God in creation, as we celebrate our heart's thanksgiving. It would, of course, be easy to focus on what we don't do this year. There's always a great and wonderful decorated celebration. But now it's not that. Let's focus on what we can do. We're just come to give thanks to God for all that He's given us. To worship our Lord, our Creator, our Father. And to do the service, to bring tokens of our thanks. We do that a bit later. And a reminder that the produce we give today will go to support local need through the National Pantry, the food bank that we're running through Scholars Church. And any donations of money you give specifically for harvest will go to support the work of the Brothers of the Good Shepherd. And we'll have a short video from them explaining how their harvest is working this year with the service. As always, you'll find the words of the service are in the orders. So follow up, please. As in the moments together, we keep silent for God. And perhaps think of one or two particular things for which each of us is thankful for this day. Pray together. Lord, direct our thoughts and teach us to pray. Lift up our hearts to worship you with spirit and with truth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this. Hear, Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this. Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Amen.
Amen. Let us confess our forgetfulness to the needs of the poor and repent of the ways which we waste the resources of the world. As we confess our sin and the sins of our society and the misuse of God's creation. God our Father, we are sorry for the times when we've used your gifts carelessly and acted ungratefully. Hear our prayer and, in your mercy, forgive us
and help us.
We enjoy the fruits of the harvest, but sometimes forget that you've given them to us. Father, in your mercy,
forgive us and help us.
We belong to a people who are full and satisfied, but ignore the cry of the hungry. Father, in your mercy,
forgive us and help us.
We are faultless and do not care enough for the world you've made. Father, in your mercy,
forgive us and help us.
We store up goods for ourselves alone, as if there were no God and no heaven. Father, in your mercy,
forgive us
and help master of the world to save us, bringing his pardon and peace now and forever.
Amen.
If you're able, will you please stand to respond to God's forgiveness with words of praise taken from Psalm 67. We begin by saying together, the earth has yielded its harvest. God has blessed us. You visit the earth and water it.
You make it rain and rain.
You soften the ground with showers.
And bless the increase of it.
You crown the air with your goodness.
And your paths shall flow with plenty.
The meadows are clothed with sheep.
The house stands so thick with corn. They shout with joy and ceasing.
The earth is healed as harvest.
God, our God, has blessed us.
You stand as prayer. You'll find the prayer and Bible readings on the sheet. Creator God, you made the goodness of the land, the riches of the sea, and the rhythm of the seasons. As we thank you for the harvest, may we cherish and respect this planet and its peoples. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. We sit for our first Bible.
The one who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and the one who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each of you must give as you have made up your mind, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to provide you with every blessing in abundance. So that by always having enough of everything, you may share abundantly in every good work. As it is written, he scatters abroad, he gives to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. He who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed for sowing, and increase the harvest of your righteousness. You will be enriched in every way for your great generosity, which will produce thanksgiving to God through us. For the rendering of this ministry not only supplies the needs of the saints, but also overflows with many thanksgivings to God. Through the testing of this ministry, you glorify God by your obedience to the confession of the gospel of Christ, and by the generosity of your sharing with them and with all others, while they long for you and pray for you because of the surpassing grace of God that he has given you. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Paul taught that generosity, both our possessions as well as of our hearts, was part of our response to the good news of Jesus. When he wrote those words, he was encouraging the Corinthians to support their brothers and sisters in the area around Jerusalem, where there was a famine. And giving to support those in need has always been part of our harvest celebrations. Usually, then, the produce of the grain as well as donations goes to the Good Shepherd, But this year, as well as the very local need, which we're aware, the brothers have asked us to be cast a bit differently. So before we hear our gospel reading, I'm just going to play a short video from them, which sets out how they are seeing and answering called whilst this year. So please, whether it's a donation you bring as part of our today, or any way you can donate to support the work of Good Shepherd over the coming weeks, please do. And of course, if you want to bring in a donation as part of our offering over the next couple of weeks, you put it in an envelope marked Good Shepherd Harvest, then we will make sure it gets passed on to them. But But now we please stand as together we hear the reading of the Holy Gospel.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Lift up your eyes and see the fields are ripe for harvest. Gather the fruits for eternal life.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hear the Gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Jesus told the people the parable. The ground of a certain rich man produced a good crop. He thought to himself, what shall I do? I have no place to store my crops. Then he said, this is what I will do. I will tear down my barns and build bigger ones, and there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I'll say to myself, you have plenty of good things laid up for many years. Take life easy, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said to him, you fool, this very night your life will be demanded from you. Then who will get what you have prepared for yourself? This is how it will be with anyone who stores up things for himself, but is not rich towards God. Then Jesus said to his disciples, therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life and what you will eat, but about your body, what you will wear. Life is more than food, and the body more than clothes. Consider the ravens. They do not sow or reap. They have no storeroom or barn, yet God feeds them. And how much more valuable are you than birds? Who on you, by worrying, can add a single hour to his life? Since you cannot do this very little thing, why do you worry about the rest? Consider how the lilies grow. They do not labor or spin. Yet I tell you, not even Solomon in his splendor was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and tomorrow is thrown into the fire, how much more will he clothe you? O you of little faith. And do not set your heart on what you will eat or drink. Do not worry about it. The pagan world runs after all such things, and your Father knows you need them. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Lord of harvest, give us confidence in your love, your plan, your promise to us. Amen.
Amen.
You too. Usually at harvest, when we hear that wonderful passage about the birds and the flowers, it's from Matthew's Gospel. It's only Luke, whose version we read today, who links it with that rather less reassuring story about the rich landowner who had plenty of food but not enough time. Even without that jarring introduction, Jesus called us not to worry. It's often hard to take on board. And surely more so than usual just now. Don't worry isn't the easy fear that we learn to do. When so many of us have been through so much, or fear what might be around the corner over the coming months. But actually, it's at times like these that we need to hear those words of challenge and reassurance. And perhaps also, at times like these, we need to hear the first part of that reading to give us the big picture. After all, when Jesus spoke those words, he wasn't talking to people who had a lot of control over their own circumstances. He was speaking mostly to peasants. Peasants living in an occupied country. Peasants who could never be sure what the next day, let alone the next week or month would bring. And the story he tells is about someone who is so focused on the medium-term future, the coming months and years of plenty for him, that he doesn't either enjoy the riches of the harvest that he has in the present moment, or think of giving them away to help others, to share with those who are in need. He's so focused on what might be around the corner, perhaps worrying about his future. And all he can think of is storing his good things away for the next many years. Now, there's nothing wrong, of course, with sensible preparation for the future. But we need to face, and more so now than ever, the reality that there are so many unknowns in the coming years that we're never going to be able to guard ourselves against anything. And so we need to hear Jesus' challenge, as he calls us to focus less on the coming months and years, and more on the two time frames that we can really have confidence in, eternity and now. For eternity, Jesus calls us to use what we have in ways that will please God, including with the generosity and the care for others that we heard about in our first meeting. It's all part of shaping our character for eternity. Being generous with what we have is not about somehow pleasing God so that we get to heaven more easily. The confidence we have in eternity is because we know where we're headed. For eternal life with God, which Jesus has won for us and has promised to us. And nothing that happens next week or next year can change that. We know where we're headed. Eternity is absolutely secure. But living in the light of eternity, living in a way that makes sense when you have eternal life, is God's gift. That's fair. Using what we have wisely and generously comes in. Living, earning, saving, spending in the way of Jesus. And harvest aligns us up that perspective. Though what we do now matters, because eternity matters. So, we have confidence in eternity, and in the light of that, we make decisions about how we live and spend and everything else. The only other moment that we know for sure we have is now, this instant. One of the tragedies of life is when we are always so wrapped up in the past or future, in last year or next month, that actually we miss now while it's happening. When Jesus calls us to consider the ravens and to consider the lilies, he doesn't mean just give them a passing thought. He doesn't mean think of these bits of nature, creation, as a wonderful idea. He means to stop and look at them. To put down everything else, for a few minutes, just watch the birds in the sky. Do step aside from the path and the hurry, and look at the flower or tree leaf as it begins to go brown, and really look and be absorbed. And just enjoy that moment. When we allow ourselves to be absorbed into wonder at God's creation, then for a moment we stop worrying about the things that we can't control. We focus instead on the things we don't need to control, just to consider and enjoy. If you can't stop worrying, why does someone stop worrying? But you can stop worrying by starting to do something else that absorbs you, that reminds you that you are here and this is now, and that you are in the world that God has made, and He is pleased with you. So we have now, and we have eternity, and in between there's a lot of uncertainty, but what we know is that God will be with us in all the moments between now and then. So let's not lose the joys of what we know. Let's not lose the thankfulness and gift of this moment, because our fears can be unknown. So please, this harvest time, enjoy God's gifts to you. Look for the chance to use them to help others, and take time to stop a moment, to watch the birds, or look at the trees and the plants, and just minutes, be still. For God is with you, and He always will be. Amen.
Amen.
Now, if you're able to stand, and place my usual creed, then of our hearts worship, simply give thanks to God, the God of all peoples. The phrase, bring our thanks to the Lord, is your mercy and your spirit. For the colour and forms of your creation and for our place within it, we bring our thanks to the Lord.
Your mercy and your spirit.
For our daily food and for those whose work and skill bring your good gifts to us, we bring our thanks to the Lord.
Your mercy and your
support ever. For the gifts and graces inspired in human minds and hearts, for insight and imagination, for the skills of research which bring healing and fulfillment to the lives of men, we bring our thanks to the Lord.
Your mercy and your support ever.
For the light and shades of the changing seasons and their variety and dependability, for new life and growth out of barrenness and decay, we bring our thanks to the Lord.
Your mercy endures forever.
For all in whose lives we see goodness, kindness, gentleness, patience, and humility, and all the fruit of the Spirit, we bring our thanks to the Lord.
Your mercy and your support.
For the life we've been given, and for all those who you've given us to share it, we bring our thanks to the Lord.
Your mercy and your support.
And now, to continue our thankfulness, we're going to bring forward any gifts that you've brought with you, work the good man or the good shepherd. Now, we're not allowed to sing, but it is unthinkable you can have a Church of England harvest service without the melodies and scatter. So if you're allowed to come, or just to pray the words in your heart, but as we put this on the screen, if you please, in the same way we did for communion, come to the front and down and back to the side. Those of you who are in the gallery, if you prefer to keep your gifts with you until you come down for communion, rather than come down and twice, please feel free to do that, or come down and join us now. And those of you who are joining us from home, then you may feel that this is a good time to look at the details for the Brothers of the Good Shepherd and to make a donation to their work as part of our worship. So now as we hear that great gift, our gifts are scattered, we bring in thanks our gifts. He was, but indeed our prayers today, but unfortunately not well. And so we do the traditional prayers for Harvest Thanksgiving. Let's pray. First, Father, we offer to your service in thanks these gifts that you brought. We ask your blessing on the work of the food bank at the park. On the Brothers of the Good Shepherd, reaching out with your love to our neighbours in need. Bless these gifts for your glory and the good of others, as we offer them with thankful hearts. Amen.
Amen.
prayers to God for the life of the world and for all God's people in their daily life and work. Each time I say, Lord, all life, or creation, or wisdom, whatever, each time we answer, hear our prayer. Lord of all, hear our prayer. God, the beginning and end of all things, in your providence and care you watch unceasingly over all creation. We offer our prayers that in us and in all your people, your will may be done according to your wise and loving purpose in Christ our Lord. Lord of all life,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all through whom we receive sustenance and life, for farmers and agricultural workers, for packers, distributors, and company boards. As you so ordered our life, we depend upon each other. Enable us by your grace to seek the well-being of others before our own. Lord of all creation, hear our prayer. We pray for all engaged in research, to safeguard crops against disease, and to produce abundant life from among those who hunger, whose lives are at risk. But this time we pray especially for all seeking to find vaccines, treatments, and all that is needed to slow and to end the spread and effects of the COVID virus. Prosper the work of their hands and the searching of their minds, that they labour may be for the welfare of all. Lord of all wisdom, hear our prayer. We pray for governments and aid agencies, and for those areas of the world where there is disaster, drought, and starvation. By the grace of your Spirit, touch our hearts and the hearts of all who live in comfortable plenty. Make us wise stewards of your gifts. Lord of all justice,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are ill, remembering those in hospitals and nursing homes, and all who are known to us. We pray for all who care for them. Give skill and understanding to all who work for their well-being. Lord of all compassion,
hear.
We remember those who died, whom we entrust to your eternal love in the hope of resurrection to new life. Lord of all peace,
hear.
We offer ourselves to your service, asking that by the Spirit at work in us, others may receive the rich harvest of love and joy and peace. Lord of all faithfulness,
hear our prayer.
God of grace, as you are ever at work in your creation, so fulfill your wise and loving purpose in us and in all for whom we pray, that with them and in all that you've made, your glory may be revealed and the whole earth give praise to you. Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
If you are able, would you stand? The harvest of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And now, let the butcher one another, do please greet one another with a sign of God's peace.
Let's listen to our Lord.
Blessed are you, O God of all creation, who creates the fruits of the vine.
When
all the hearts. With joy we offer thanksgiving for your love and creation, and have shared in the bread and wine with you. By your grace, plant within us a reverence for all that you give us, and make us generous and wise stewards of the good things we enjoy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Published the banns of marriage between Adrian Ronald Donovan and Hayley Alexander Magnus, both of this parish. This is for the first time I ask. If any of you know reason and law why this person will not be joining in holy matrimony, you are to declare it. And they ought there to be nervous. Let's pray. Father, of your great love, you give us love for one another. We pray for these your children as they prepare for marriage. In these coming weeks, bless them. Draw them closer to one another as you draw them closer to yourself. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Just a few announcements before we finish this morning. First, usual reminder that at the end of the service, we are asked to save any conversation for outside, please. And even keep that as limited as we reasonably can. Don't forget that we mustn't gather more than 6 people total. And you just still need people within that to keep that usual 2 metres of distance safety. We know that the virus is spreading rapidly. Please, let's be careful and careful. On Tuesday, I'm posting on YouTube and Facebook, and links everywhere else I can, the first video introducing a Bible study on God of the Mountaintops. We did that this year by some videos posted online. Now, if you would like me to put some DVD and get it to you, then please do let me know. You can't use the internet. I will make sure to get a copy to you. The video will go up on Tuesday. And then a week tomorrow, then in the evening, we'll do the first online discussions. Think through some of the issues that has raises. Think through how meaning you've got in the physical and spiritual mountaintops of life. Also this week, on Wednesday, I'm delighted that we'll have the first for several months of our Wednesday evening service at 10:05. It will, of course, look similar to this in how we'll be seated in space and doing things. But if that's being part of your worship, or it's something you want to try as to help you worship God through the week, please do join us at 10:00 on Wednesday. On Thursday, and again online, for safety, we have our PCC meeting. This is the wider team church council. I've emailed out papers for this, and I'll send them out to members on WhatsApp. If you need printed papers again, please let me know and we'll get them to you. Looking further ahead, in 3 weeks' time, at the end of our morning service, we'll have a short annual meeting of the church. So please do join us for that. We'll have the reports out in advance and invite questions in advance so keep things as short as possible. If you would like to stand for election, do deem yourself as a ward member of the DCO for DCC, and please do see me on the wards after the service and get that organised. Any other general announcements? Then I will mention a couple of birthdays, but I'm not sure that either of those here are not to mention any which happy birthdays, they may go online to Dorrie Tans, but also we know Sharon's birthday yesterday. So
So Sharon, if you're joining us from home, many happy returns. And any of you who have missed out on the birthday chocolates, I'm sorry, you weren't here last week. There are some on the table there. Please, only if you've had a birthday, have another birthday chocolate. No problem, thank you. Let's stand to share God's blessing. May God, our Creator, who clothes the lilies and feeds the birds of the air, bestow on you his care and increase the heart of your righteousness. And the blessing of God, my Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Freely you receive, freely give.